Good morning, everyone. Good to see you today. My name is Joey. Here, where are we? Calvary Community Church, Fellowship of Deaf and Hearing Believers. We all welcome you all together and do an announcement today. Today is November 8th, if you didn't know that. Today we have a church fellowship at Shakey's today. The Shakey is located at 11403 Firestone Boulevard. If you go down Pioneer and turn left on Firestone, and they'll be right on the corner of Imperial and Firestone. So I hope to see you guys all there after church. We're going to have to fight for some seats probably. So are you guys ready to fight? Read the Bible if we could do that. There's a Deaf Revival 2015 next week. So if you need information about the flyers. There's a Deaf Expo next week too. The reason why I put it up there is because we should go and be out there to show the light. Share Jesus Christ, show the light. People to see us, they can see Jesus. So be nice to people out there, okay? We have a church decorating November 27th. I doubt it was a Saturday, but it's really a Friday. So we have to be here at 6 p.m., okay? Who's coming? I'm glad you're coming. So Fred's going to look at you, write down your names. If you're not here, you're in big trouble. We have a church program and a banquet on December 13th. All right. Adults, it costs $15 for the banquet. 13 and up. 13 and 12 and below is $7. We're selling tickets. You want to buy tickets for it? Go to Maple. See? And the deadline is what? The 6th. December 6th, the deadline to buy tickets. There's a Deaf Women's Retreat next year, March 11th and 13th. Just a reminder, if you need flyers, they're back there. They might be out. We'll get some more next week. Life, but God is bigger. Your God is greater. A few more things about the Christmas drama. For the banquet, first thing, we have PayPal. You can pay for the tickets online. The Christmas drama, Pastor Linda passed out calendars, so make sure you look at it and don't miss it, like I did. So be here for the drama and practice. So look at the calendar. Let me say something?
Yeah. If for some reason your practice time on the calendar is at a time you can't make it, please contact me and let me know. We can practice at night or we can practice any day of the week. It doesn't have to be on Saturday, but every main character in the drama needs to practice with me. You people who have parts and you don't know how to sign, someone has to teach you. So that's me. So be sure you come and say, I need help, because we're less than 1 month away now. So everyone needs to be practicing with me. And if you need me to go through your part slowly with you, fine, just contact me, let me know.
She needs to teach me how to sign. Okay, we have a special singer today. Let's welcome Naomi. Yeah, I'm going to pray. Father Heaven, Lord, for us, the blessings you have given us, all you have done for us financially, the homes, the food you provided for us, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for the opportunity to give to you and return back to you, Lord. Thank you, in Jesus' name, pray. Amen. Are you guys ready to worship the Lord? I am.
We have the nursery room open back there. Leslie's taking care of that. And that's for age 6 and under. Jose, you cannot go. You have to stay here. You're above 6 years old. Maybe you don't act like it, but you are. And we have a kids' class over here. Anyone wants to go to the kids' class? All right, guys. Josie knows the way. And we're allowing Big Sister to go with her, Belinda, with him. Good morning, Hector. I saw you rubbing your eyes. You're still asleep. Okay, that's fine. Did you bring your Bibles today? Morning, Robert. You didn't bring your Bible? Oh, no pointing fingers. Okay. All right, no pointing fingers. Open them up. What happened? 2 Kings. Chapter 13. Verses 14 through 19. Several verses you have to read. I might call you to come up here and read the verse for me. Oh, you don't know? Oh, okay. She was freaking out. Okay. I want to talk about this. Now, I preached this message way long ago. I know my wife already remembers it. Carter, do you remember it? She doesn't remember it. All right. Who else remembers this message? He remembers. That's good. I'm glad that you are forgetful. No. Because today you will remember it. And you won't forget it. What is in your hand? I hope it's a Bible. Yeah. Elizabeth? There's nothing in her hand. Oh. I'm going to talk about how you're going to read that when it's zipped up. You have to unzip it. To read it. Oh, thank you, Moises. Reading 2 Kings, starting verse 14. When Elisha, he became sick with illness. And because of that sickness, Elisha, hey, he's going to die. He's going to die from that sickness, okay? And but the king's name was I need the support section on the front row to remain quiet. I know you know all the answers, Dr. Cruz. But what's the king's name?
Joash.
Thank you. Joash is the name of the king. Now, Elisha, he was dying, you know. And then the king came in. And he cried, my father, the chariot of Israel. You see, the king is losing Elisha. Elisha is the king's support. The king depended on him. Now, I'm trying to release everything I'm doing, and I'm depending on Joey to do things around here, and I'm depending on others. Belinda's taking up the run for the funds, and, you know, because, now, understand, we're not dying. But we are leaving. Sad, I know. I'm surprised I didn't hear any cheers. So I'm trying to get you ready for what's new coming. And you see, Joash depended on Elisha. And Elisha said to him, take the bow and arrows. How many of you are archers? Your brother-in-law, but no one's an archer? What?
Upside down.
Oh. She told me it's upside down. That's me. Come up here, smarty. And hold it for me. My hand over here. My hand won't let me hold it. A little closer. Just keep it pointed that way. Don't want that. Now, Elisha told the king, he says, hey, take your bow and arrow. Oh, run get me about 3 more arrows. Open the door. I need some more arrows. He said, take the bow and arrows. And then, so he took the bow and arrows. And Elisha, take the bow and arrows. Elisha told him, which way's up? Oh. Hey, I'm the old-fashioned kind. You can do it either way. And he told him, said, put your hand on the bow. You got that. And then Elisha has a point. Whew. Now, I don't know exactly. Don't point it towards them. They're afraid. Elisha put his hand on, okay, Joash's hand. Yeah. And said, and then he told him, hey, go open the east window. What? Where's east? It's that away. So face that away. Yeah. East. He said, now I'm sure there must have been a west window or a north window or something else, but he told him, said, open the east window. You got it? And he opened it. And then he told him, said, shoot! East. Now, the reason why I chose her is because she can't pull it back. Now, Leslie, that's Leslie's bow, but she's taking care of the children today back there. Leslie can pull it back and shoot it. That's a good point there. I don't know if I could pull it back. I have a crank on my crossbow. I don't pull it. It's too hard. I have a crank. But anyway, told him to shoot. And let's see, then what did he do? Oh, he shot. So shoot it best you can.
Where?
Right back there. That's good enough. Oh, you didn't shoot it.
It's gonna whack me.
Oh. Good job. Thank you. Oh, one more. So he shot it, and then he said, "Oh, take the arrows and strike the ground." I'm on verse 18. I don't know what happened back there. Really? Three times. Thank you. You may be seated. Good job, Carter. So he took the arrows, he struck the ground three times, and he stops. And then the man of God, what's the name of the man of God?
Elisha.
Oh, I thought it was Fred Orr. Okay. Elisha. He was mad. He was mad. Yeah? So the man of God was angry. You should have struck the ground five or six times. What's up with you? Because if you struck it that many times, then you would have struck Aram until you would have destroyed it, the enemy over there. But now you will strike Aram only three times, and that's it. Father God, I ask for your help today to help explain to these people and to myself your words and the meaning of these words. In the name of Jesus, amen. These are prophetic words. Prophetic words, what's that? Prophetic words are things that are said to you that mean something about you or for you. Is that right, Doc? Oh, good. Hey, I got an A+ so far. Huh. Huh? Oh, prophetic words from God. Okay? It's prophetic words from God. Now, on your program, how many of you got a program? Only two or three. We don't have a greeter back there, but on the back of it, there's a list. Jose is going to help you. The first thing it talked about in this scripture, Elijah told him to get a bow. To get a bow. He got the bow. This bow represents I'll give him a second. Mildred, you need to teach him how to do it faster. Okay? Ah, glory. Thank you, Jose. The first thing talked about in this scripture was the bow. The bow is the power of the Holy Spirit in your life. That's what it represents. And then it talks about the arrows. I can't say that word. This is the specific. This is the specific words of God to you personally. What's that? It's this book right here. This book is God's specific words for you and I. Personally. Next, we find he talked about your hand, the king's Joash hand. That hand, his putting the hand on the bow is you taking responsibility. Yeah? Some of us need to take up some responsibility. Hey, just let me tell you about the church. The church needs someone to stand back there in the morning to greet people. Hi! And give out the programs. That's what's needed. Taking responsibility. Now, also, there's another responsibility here that these arrows represent. It also represents the responsibility you and I have to allow God to move in me. Yeah. Responsibility to allow God to move in me. I respond to Him. The hands represented your submission to God. Also, submission to God in the next season. Now, we're facing some changes around here because we are obeying God and we're departing. And God's not yet placed in a new pastor yet. Hey, not to worry. I'm not concerned yet. But, hey, God has something planned for this church. God has something planned for you. Okay? We have to reach out and take hold of God for this next season. Then we look at Elisha's hand. You put your hand on it, and then God put Elisha's hand on his hand. God's hand on you. Elisha's hand represents God's hand on your life. It's important that we understand this. You don't just touch the Word of God, you take it. And God, this Word is for me. The promises of God are for me. I take it. I use it. I make it part of my life. This Word of God becomes part of my life. Really, Elisha's hand on Joash's hand represents a cooperation. You see, you have to allow God's hand upon you. You have to allow God's hand His Spirit to touch us, to touch our minds, to touch us. Working together in unity. We have to cooperate with Holy Spirit. It's important that you understand this. Sometimes we do things half-hearted. Take out the trash. How many of you cried when mom or dad told you to take out the trash? Some of you were perfect children. Most of you were perfect children. Take out the trash? Yeah. You know, we do it. Whew. Now, back in my day, I knew if I didn't, it was, yeah. But you get in trouble. Therefore, I half-heartedly, I better get off the subject. I'm preaching at myself now. But you need to get it in your head that your previous experiences of failure has nothing to do with your current success, your ability. Your past failures really have nothing to associated with your ability to have success in the future. When the Spirit of God comes upon us, your persona, it all changes when the Spirit of God is on us. And right now, I think we need to open the east window. That window represents a season of opportunity. How many of you open your windows at home? Yeah, all of us do here in California. I have my window open in my bedroom. I shut it last night because I was a little cold. But anyway, do you leave the window open all winter? Well, there's some weirdo. I mean, there are some people who do that. Here you can do that. Go north or east. You're not going to leave your window open all winter long. Carter, what's the temperature in your room, a bedroom? Was it 40? Or maybe, well, outside, I think, at her home, it's almost in the 30s today. She's from Missouri. But she's not going to sleep with the window open unless she has the heat on blasting. You see, windows do not open permanently. Windows of God do not open permanently. Windows from God are prophetic, something for you, but it's seasonal. There's a time limit. The windows represent a certain space in time. It's just like with Noemi, she sang a special today. Oh, and if you want, you can do the same, vocal or sign language, it doesn't matter. If you play the piano, come on. Oh, you know what? I saw a video this week of someone playing the drums. Oh, you saw that too? And I think next week she should be right over here during worship playing the drums. You agree? Two agree. We're going to take a vote. All in favor? Amanda, did you get that? She says she quit and she's leaving the church. Oh. If you do that, hey, we need you. I'm off the subject. But there's a window of opportunity. Pastor Linda asked Noemi if she would sing a special. Now, that time, there was a time limit on it. She didn't know it. But if she didn't say yes, I doubt Pastor Linda would have asked her again the second time. Maybe. You see, there are windows of opportunity in your life that open, and you have to grab that pie and run with it. Oh, you've never done that. Okay. I have prayed often, and I've seen it. Open, what is that song? Open the windows of heaven. I don't know that song. she has all the songs up here. But I prayed. I said, Lord, open the windows of heaven and pour out your spirit. Well, let me tell you something. God is saying to you, the window, it's open. It's open. It's not going to happen. It is open. It's a window of opportunity for you to begin to do something for God. That will change your life. It will help other people. But let me tell you, it's seasonal. I need to talk about the east window, or the east. East. Did we already get the east? escape and find it. Maybe I didn't put it on there. East is a new day. A new day when everything changes. That's the East. A new day. The window, opportunity, it's the East. It's a new day. Hey. Renewal is permanent. Now, opportunity is seasonal. It happens now and then. Opportunity happens now and then. But renewal is permanent. Therefore, you have a short time to take advantage to become permanently changed. And then the next one was shoot. The word shoot represents your obedience to believe God and to cooperate with Him. People, you only win if you shoot. You're not going to win if you just draw it back and let it down. You have to draw it back and let it go. Then you can win. It represents becoming obedient. We need to continue to obey Him. This season of time here is not just power and glory and breakthrough, but it's a time of obedience. The arrows of the Lord's deliverance, it means freedom to become what God wants me to do next. Arrow of deliverance. That arrow of deliverance from the enemy in my life. I'm going to work on it. Perhaps you have an enemy in your life. I have one. I have an enemy. And it pops up. If you don't know that sign language, that's burp. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm too dignified. I have an enemy. I love to burp. What? I know, okay, I'm a little weird. You can ask them. I can do it. Boom! But is that polite? Oh, I got one yes! Maybe we need to vote on this. In the Filipino culture? That's fine. Ooh, I'm moving. So I'm working on that enemy. But there's other enemies in our lives also that are spiritual. And maybe that's a spiritual thing. Anyway, I'm working on ceasing. Your enemy is energy drinks. I don't know if that's an enemy or not. I think maybe that's...
Yes,
the wife said, yes, it is. I'm staying out of this one. I'm not getting involved in that discussion. Let's move on. Strike. Oh, I missed one. Okay. The place of the enemy's superiority. This represents the top one. Affect. I don't know how you say that word. Your enemy will be overcome. Strike means to apply God's word in my life. And then we have the ground. The ground is your current situation. What's happening in your life right now? That's the ground. Maybe the series of battles. But what is happening is God is coming to fight your battle. I declare that today over you, that God is coming to fight your battle for you. God is coming to fight your battle. Yeah. And I take hold of it right here. I take hold of it. He will make the war against what's happening in your life. You have to grasp hold of the bow. You have to allow His hand on your hand. Your answers. God, give me the answers. What I speak. Your life's in trouble? Hey, God will come, and this trouble that's coming against me, God will come and fight that trouble. He's declaring war on it. The church, that's you and I, must be positioned to receive what God is releasing. You have to get in a place to receive what God is releasing. There's some easy fights and there's some hard fights. But the Lord wants you to know the harder the fight, the bigger the breakthrough. But you have to learn to fight with Him. Stand in faith. Believe in Him. Allow Him to speak and move in power. The hearing people are hearing the baby cry. Paul, make sure that door's shut. It's a distraction, but it should not be a distraction. The principle is this. When the opportunity of a lifetime comes, make sure you act within the lifetime of that opportunity. Let me explain. You have 5 seconds to come and take this money. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You missed it. Well, he didn't miss.
I wanted to do that.
He's been wanting to do that all the time. Next time I'll know. Get it out there. That's what this means. You have an opportunity limited right here. God's opened the windows. But God's not going to leave it open. You have to make the decision, I'm going to step in, I'm going to get what God's offering me right now, today. I'm not going to postpone His deliverance, I'm not going to postpone His help, I'm not going to put off serving Him anymore. Boy, I'll survive. We have to learn to obey. The good news, the window's open, and God will fight for you. Now there's one thing that's not, is that the last one on the list? Is that the last one? What's the last one? I must not have put them all. Let me see that. I have one right there. Strike the ground. Oh well. There's one more that the scripture really doesn't talk about. But that is, let me see if I hold this right. Ah, there we go. Come here, Carter. My left hand doesn't function that well. The string. The string. For this to function properly, that string has to be pulled back. She almost did it. Almost did it. It has to be pulled back. It's stretched. Unless you allow yourselves to be stretched, your arrow will not, and that's it. Grab me my arrow, please. Put it in. I want to demonstrate this again. Right here, right that direction. Don't pull it as far as you did last time. Come on, a little bit. Let go. That's the point. You have to. No, no, no. Okay. Hold it. Stretch it.
It's got 40 pounds of weight.
Oh. The pull has more weight than she weighs. Oh, I see. The flight of that arrow depends on how, if you can pull it back all the way. If you do not allow God to stretch me, change me, use me, hey, you're going to go poof, that's it. Not much is going to happen in your life if you do not allow Holy Spirit to come in. If you do not allow Holy Spirit to come in, not much is going to happen. You have to surrender. Allow Him to stretch us so we can succeed for Him. Stand up. I'm asking God that you come, that you, God, stretch me and come in and use me and change my life, that I can become more powerful for you in the name of Jesus. God, I'm asking that you just come into these people's lives, that you begin to fight the battle for them. Amen. Putting that aside, you as individuals have to decide to grasp hold of the bow. It's grasping hold.
There is someone here today that's been struggling with a decision. And it's something new to you. And you feel like you're supposed to do it, but you're afraid. And you've been putting it off and putting it off and putting it off, but your window of opportunity is getting near the close. The time is going to be over. You need to move on it. God is telling you through this message today, the decision that you've been feeling like you should make, but you've been afraid to make it, is going to come to a close soon. And you need to move forward with it. It's God's plan. It's something God wants for you. It's something that will have good benefits for you if you're obedient. And it will be a great loss to you if you let the window close. If that sounds like you today, I encourage you, move forward.
Jesus. If you want to make that decision, come on up right now.
Surrender to God, saying,
here I am. I'm going to do.
Jesus. Holy. Lord Jesus, we submit to you, Lord. We submit to you, God. Lord, we say, okay.
Father God.
We will do it, God. Okay. We will obey.
praise your name, Jesus.
God wants to lead you,
yes,
into
Lord,
new things,
yes, Lord,
for Him, Jesus, and for His kingdom. Make sure you step into that open window of opportunity. Make sure you step into what God wants you to do. Don't leave here today without making a commitment to Him. Amen? Today is our Fellowship Sunday, the second Sunday of every month. Pastor Linda and I are not able to go